Hey friends, as an Azure customer myself, I am always looking for ways to save money and pinch some pennies in the cloud. Yashesvi Sharma is here to show us how Azure Reserved VM instances can save up to 80% or even more over pay-as-you-go pricing. We're going to learn all about it today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Yashesvi Sharma. We're talking about Azure Reservations. You have a way for me to save money. I've got lots of virtual machines running in Azure, and I love to find ways to pinch pennies in the cloud. What is Azure Reservations?
Scott, Azure Reservations is a way for you to pre-purchase your virtual machines' compute usage for a duration of 1 or 3 years.
Okay. And is this like leasing a car? Like, I know I'm going to be in Azure for a year or 3 years.
Yeah.
Just pay up front.
Yeah, you can think of it that way, yes. If you're going to use a VM 24/7, 365 days a year, your base consistent usage, you should just buy reservations and save up to 80% on that usage.
That's fantastic. Now, that seems like a huge amount. Like, it's not 10% or 20%.
Yeah.
It's 60, 70, 80%. Why so much? How is that possible?
Well, there is really two things. One, you're committing to the usage over a long period of time.
Okay.
And it also gives us visibility into your demands for the data center usage.
I see. So you know that that VM is going to be running for that time. So for capacity planning, it makes it easier for Azure.
Yes.
I see. So then when I do this, do I pay upfront, just pay all at once, and I just don't think about paying for the next 1 or 3 years?
So you just pay upfront for reservation, and we stop charging you on demand for a matching VM.
Oh, okay, for a matching VM.
Yeah.
So it's not for any VM, it's not like a discount card. I am buying a SKU and a location?
Yes, you buy a reservation for a region and for a VM size. And the reservation applies on that matching VM in your usage.
Okay, and I wouldn't want to turn that VM on and off then. It really is for VMs that are in full usage, right? If I turn it off, I've still paid.
Yes.
So I don't. It doesn't save me any money.
Yeah, it's best for customers who have consistent base usage. If you shut it off, you've still paid for it. In that case, you want to keep your VMs running.
Mm-hmm. Now, another thing that we have in Azure Compute that saves huge amounts is this low priority VM.
Mm-hmm.
That's for VMs that don't matter as much,
can
go away at any time, and I would like to say I don't deeply care about those VMs.
Mm-hmm.
It's for compute workloads that are bursty.
Mm-hmm.
But this is for VMs that I care about.
Yeah, this is your main base usage. This is for workloads that you want to run 24/7, not your interruptible workloads.
Okay, so then I should look at all of the different VMs that I currently use, and there should be a huge opportunity for me to take. So I have, like myself, 2 or 3 VMs that are in the cloud, but someone else might have hundreds.
Yes.
And they could save huge money on all of those hundreds that are running 24/7.
Yeah, so it really, just customers, they should just look at their usage, just see what VM and region you're using consistently over a period of time, and you should buy reservations for that for that consistent usage.
What if I buy like a basic or a D series, and then in 18 months, I'm halfway through my 3 years, and my company becomes very popular.
Mm-hmm.
And I need a bigger VM. I need to upgrade or scale up that VM, but I've paid for a smaller one.
Yeah. So reservations are there for standard series, not for basic, but standard. Let's say you have D series and you later want to move to E series or your workload demand changes.
Okay.
You can exchange a reservation.
Nice.
There is unlimited exchanges that you can perform, and there is no penalty on exchange.
Well, this is great. This makes me feel like, again, I go to like renting or leasing a car, right?
Mm-hmm.
You buy a basic car or a standard car instead,
mm-hmm.
and you want to get a deluxe car.
Yeah.
You just take it into the rental agency and there's no penalty for the upgrade.
Yeah, that's exactly how it is. When you exchange, you just have to buy the new value. The new value of reservation should be greater than what you're returning.
Indeed, right. So you would not exchange down.
Yes.
Okay. That's very interesting. What if I have to cancel? Like, you break your lease. There's usually a penalty when you break a lease on a car.
Yeah, we understand that happens. If you have a need for cancellation, you can cancel it. There is a 12% early termination fee, and there is a limit of up to $50,000 in a 12-month window.
I see. So you can only cancel up to $50,000.
Yes.
So if I'm a giant company and I've bought millions and millions and millions of dollars, I wouldn't be able to cancel it all.
No.
So it prevents abuse.
Yeah, it prevents abuse. You should really plan for that VM usage in long term.
Yeah, I feel a little bad because I've had a couple VMs running for 3 years. This money's been there ready to be saved.
You can start saving now, Scott.
Fantastic, so what does the UI look like?
Okay, so let's go through the experience. Here I'm on the portal. You can go to all services and just either find reservations here.
Okay.
I have it right here. Let's click on it. This is where I can see all my reservations. I can manage my reservations.
Okay.
So this reservation I purchased yesterday. It's valid for one full year.
Okay.
And the scope is shared. We'll talk about scope a little bit more as we go into the purchase experience.
Okay.
And it is for this VM, and it's in this region. And the quantity is one. So let's go.
So just to be clear, the quantity is one. I could buy two VMs, but only one is discounted because I only have one reservation.
So I have only one reservation. If you're running two VMs, only one will be discounted. Exactly.
Makes sense. Okay, that
yeah.
makes sense.
The discount is only applied to matching number of VMs and the region and size. So we're in the purchase experience here. You have to select the subscription for the purchase. This is a subscription that we will bill. Also, this is you need to be an owner on this subscription.
Okay, that makes sense.
Once you select the subscription, the second item here is scope. There is two values for scope. One is shared. The other one is single subscription. I'm logged in as an enterprise customer. If I select shared, then this reservation is going to apply across all my subscriptions in the enterprise agreement, right?
Yeah.
So it really optimizes the usage for this reservation. If I'm not using it, someone else is using it. It guarantees that, or it increases the chances of complete utilization of my reservation.
Yeah, absolutely.
I can also select single subscription here. In that case, this reservation is only going to apply to my subscription.
Okay.
The next item here is, next selection here is region. You can select any of the regions.
Mm-hmm.
I have two regions which are recommended here. That is based on my usage over last 30 days. We analyze your usage. If you use consistently VMs in a particular region, only then do we recommend that region for the purchase.
Okay, that's a really good point. Those recommendations are personal. You're not trying to push me towards Central or East. You're literally saying you use things in Central and East. This would benefit you.
Absolutely, yeah. We are not upselling you. We are trying to save as much money as we can for you. So
nice.
We run all the logic here, and we tell you that we think that you'll save most money by looking at your usage.
Okay.
So I selected East US. In East US, I have this VM running quite a bit.
Oh, so this is even nicer. And then you also recommend the size.
Yes.
Based on usage.
Yeah.
So you know where I'm running things, and you know what I usually use. So you're already showing me the best way to save money.
Yes. We can look at that data, and we try to make your task simpler. So D2S V3, we select that region, the size. Now, the term values are 1 year and 3 year here.
Mm-hmm.
I'll select 3 year term. Your discount increases as you go for a longer term.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I will give a quantity. Let me give quantity 1 here. That's the recommended quantity because I'm just running one VM here.
Okay. Sometimes it can be a little confusing when I see like things like VM size, like D series and E series and all that kind of stuff. I would find that on the pricing page to learn which VM is right for me.
Yes, in the pricing page, we cover all the VM series there.
Okay, so that just popped up the price, and it said I can save 57%.
Yeah, that's on this size.
On that size.
On that size. I can also go and change the size to a different value here. So let's select this size, and we'll just go do a calculation. We'll look at your pricing, this specific pricing for you, and then we'll figure out what's the discount. In the discount is 70% for me.
Wow, okay. Now, is we happen to be in an Australian subscription right now, so we're seeing AUD.
Yes.
Is that cost per VM for that full year? So I just pay that one price for the full year?
This is for 3 years. This is what you're going to pay.
Oh, this is for 3 years?
This is for 3 years, yes.
Oh, wow.
You're going to pay $744 right now, and for next 3 years, you will not be charged
on demand
for one D1 V2 VM running in East US.
Oh, wow.
No on demand charges.
And like you said, if I did a shared across my subscriptions, I could maybe go and say 10.
Yes.
And then other people who are admins on that subscription or people who are involved in that subscription, as long as I've got 10 of this VM size in that region being used, the first 10 are paid for.
That's correct. So we will look at your enrollment. This is an enterprise customer here. So we'll look at your enterprise agreement and all the subscriptions under that. The 10, and then we'll discount up to 10 VMs there. If you were a WebDirect customer, then we would look at your account only, and then in that account, we will see what are the matching VMs, and we'll give you a discount on that.
So you say a WebDirect customer.
If you were a credit card customer.
So I'm a WebDirect customer then.
Exactly, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so in that case, it'll be at the account scope.
That's really cool. You know, it makes me feel good about my my rental car analogy, because mm-hmm. I could have a fleet of mm-hmm. reserved virtual machines prepaid, and I could have anyone on my team use those, and my costs are fixed, my costs are understood. What happens though in 3 years and one day? Does my VM disappear?
No, nothing happens to your VM. This is a billing benefit. Your VM will just stay intact. We will bill for your VM on on-demand rates after that duration.
I see. So if I do nothing, it just goes back to regular billing.
That's correct.
But I assume I could then maybe lease it for another 3 years.
You could absolutely purchase again for 3 years, 1 year, whatever you want.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. Now, I noticed that some price, you did one size and it was 50%, you did another size, it was 70%. So discounts, do they depend on what? On region, on size, on operating system?
Yes, on the exactly those two things, region and the size. Operating system is not discounted by reservation. The reservation only applies on the compute usage.
Oh, good to know. So it doesn't matter what I run, whether I run Linux mm-hmm. or Windows. It is about the size and the location.
Yes, the discount is on the compute. Operating system will be charged separately. Hmm. However, you can combine the reservation discount with Azure Hub benefit.
Hub.
Yes. If you have a Windows license with software assurance, mm-hmm. you can apply Azure Hub on the VM, and that will increase your savings to up to 80%.
I see. So that's when I have an enterprise where I have on-premises Windows Server licenses. Mm-hmm. I've already paid for those licenses. I've got software assurance.
Exactly.
I then apply those licenses into the cloud.
Yeah.
So if I have a hybrid situation,
yes.
maybe I'm going to lift and shift a bunch of virtual machines that are sitting under someone's desk. Mm-hmm. I can go and maybe reserve 5 or 10, apply those licenses, and save even more.
Yeah, you can combine reservations and Azure Hub benefits and increase your saving to up to 80%.
Up to 80%?
Yes.
That's like, yeah, that's crazy. I really enjoy doing Azure Friday and learning about stuff like this, because I literally, after the show, people know that I'm not joking, will go and do this to my own account and save money myself, because I pay for my Azure myself. Like, I don't have like free Microsoft employee Azure money. For my own personal account, it's my own thing and my own side stuff, and learning stuff like this makes me very happy.
Yeah.
So under pricing, does this show up under pricing when we go and look at this online?
Yeah, so this is the this is azure.com pricing page. Here I'm down to the region and the operating system, and these are the VM sizes, and these are the reservation prices.
And this is the regular pricing page. This is not a special page for reserve instances.
Yeah.
So here on the regular pricing page, I can go and see, you know, almost 10 cents an hour, but I can mm-hmm. go even down to 4 cents an hour on 1 year reserve, or almost 2 cents an hour on the 3 year reserve, 72% off.
Yeah. And you can see it all in the pricing page here.
Has this been integrated into the pricing calculator?
Yes, I have it here. So if you go to Azure Pricing Calculator, you can again enter the region and the VM, and you can see the discount percentages there as well.
Very cool. So you've got this good sized virtual machine with a lot of temporary storage, and this is a D1, so this mm-hmm. is not an S, right? This is a little bit better VM.
Yeah.
And it's got it down to $18 a month. So that discount for a much more powerful VM than the S that I'm paying for is cheaper than the S that I'm paying for if I go and buy it for 3 years.
Yeah. If you, this is, as the calculator says, you'll get a 72% discount on this, and it depends whatever VM you're comparing with.
Well, what's exciting about it, and why I'm using that S as an example, is I have a budget of about $20 a month for this virtual machine.
Yeah.
And now I can get more VM for the same price if I reserve it.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. So this is available now?
Yes. We are live, and you can go purchase that from the Azure portal yourself.
Fantastic. I am learning all about how to save huge amounts of money on my Azure compute with Azure Reserved Instances today on Azure Friday.